Coming up on today's show.
I had to get used to myself. I didn't think the same. I didn't talk the same. I didn't act the same. I was a completely different person.
All of that and more on today's show.
Welcome to the show. I'm Reverend Steve Millar, and this is my wife, Kathy. And we have a special guest on the program who was set free from witchcraft.
Welcome to the program today, Lynn Eagle. We're so glad you're here with us, and you are a member of Grace Cathedral, and you were delivered from witchcraft. Yes. And I know you have a lot you want to share with us of how you got into that as a child, and we want to hear your story of how God set you free.
Okay, I wasn't actually involved in witchcraft as a child, but there was a lot of occult practices in our family. My great-grandmother was taken over with automatic writing at a very young age, I think 7 or 8 years old, and she started having psychic experiences. I don't know a whole lot about her background, why those spirits took her over. Obviously, there had to be She had to have some occult influences.
Could you let us know what automatic writing is?
Automatic writing, the devil takes over. The handles start to shake, and they'll just write. And they'll write things.
Mm-hmm. And it'll be words.
It'll be words, and it'll be kind of like, like a prophecy, mm-hmm. or, this mm-hmm. is going to happen. Like foretelling
a future. Right,
okay?
Right.
She was told from the time she was a little girl that she had a gift from God. Mm-hmm. And so, of course, her children grew up believing that, her grandchildren, her great-grandchildren. We all thought she had a gift from God.
Which we know that's not the case.
And we know that's not true. But nobody in our family knew that.
Right.
The bottom line, as far as the devil, he is real.
Yes.
And witchcraft is real. And it's dangerous. It's nothing to play with. Mm-hmm. But the devil puts fear on people in ways that things they shouldn't be afraid of. He'll put fear of people of, getting slain in the spirit, receiving the Holy Ghost. People come into the service and hear the Holy Ghost manifest and they get scared and want to leave. They're afraid of the things that God has given to help them. Mm-hmm. But the devil backs off on the fear. He's a master of deceit and disguise, and he backs off on the fear of things that people should really mm-hmm. be afraid of. There's a lot of people involved in the occult and witchcraft that don't fully realize what they're involved in. And I didn't. I started to learn when I came to Grace Cathedral. Mm-hmm. Shortly after I got here, Reverend began the sermons on the deceit of Lucifer. And that book, everyone should read.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
God definitely gave that to him. He gave Reverend a study of demonology, and that book is right on mm-hmm. every page. And again, it's nothing to play with. But growing up,
You thought it was normal.
I thought it was normal, and there was no reason to be afraid. This was my great-grandmother, and my grandmother, her daughter, read cards. She taught me how to read cards. It seemed like a fun thing. It seemed like an interesting thing, mm-hmm. and it seemed harmless. My great-grandmother never hung out a shield that said psychic, reader, advisor. People learned about her by word of mouth, mm-hmm. and people came from all over to get advice, to ask questions, what should I do? It appeared like she was helping people.
Right.
Not that she was doing anything evil. I never saw any evil, mm-hmm. okay? And some of the manifestations that took place growing up was evil, but it didn't appear to be evil. For instance, when my great-grandmother said, when she was dying, she said, I don't know if it's possible to come back, but if I can, I'm gonna come back and I'll visit you. Well, we had a rocking chair and it was in my bedroom.
Okay.
And we could hear walking, we'd be downstairs, you could hear footsteps. In my room, the rocking chair would rock with no one in it. I'd be sleeping and I'd hear breathing right next to the bed, and I'd reach up and turn on my little bed lamp, and there was the chair. It had been in the corner when I went to bed. It's now right alongside of my chair. It's rocking. I can hear the breathing. Now her daughter, my grandmother, said, "You don't have to be afraid. It's grandma. Talk to her. She just wants to be with you." And I would talk to her. The one day I said, "Grandma, if this is really you, give me a sign." And I had a collection of bells, and all of a sudden one of the bells rang. There was nobody near it, nobody touching it, but that just let me know, okay, it's grandma. Why be afraid? I remember rocking my son in the rocking chair when he was a baby and feeling a hand on my shoulder. It was grandma. She just wanted to be with us.
So that's how you were raised to believe, but later you found out that that was really a familiar spirit.
It was actually, and this is how the devil deceives people when they go to psychics, because mm-hmm. they'll say they're calling up their dead loved ones. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they'll even see them. They'll hear their voice. They'll tell them things that nobody could possibly know.
Right.
And they think it's their dead loved one. It is actually a demonic spirit that has taken on all the characteristics of their loved one. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And they don't realize that that's what it is.
Right, like, and that's biblical.
Yeah, it's like Kathy said, you know, it's a familiar spirit. When that grandma, when your grandma was rocking in that rocking chair, that's considered a familiar spirit.
Right,
that,
it was, you know, a demon, but I didn't see it in its ugly form.
It's a demonic spirit, but a familiar spirit is someone who, he mimics, you know, your loved one, mimics maybe another person. It can be, that person can be dead or alive.
Yeah, one of the things I learned in the occult, everything the devil does parallels what God does. Mm-hmm. He was taught by God, mm-hmm. okay? Mm-hmm. We all know we have a guardian angel, and that angel's with us all the time. Well, the devil assigns an angel too, mm-hmm. and it's a familiar spirit. Mm-hmm. It knows all about you. It takes on your characteristics. Mm-hmm. And that's what people are seeing when these mediums and these psychics call up their mm-hmm. dead loved ones. It's not actually them. And when I would do spells on people, I would command their spirit to appear before me, and I might actually see that person. I knew it wasn't that person. I knew it was a spirit, but I didn't realize it was a demonic spirit.
So,
you know, I didn't know that when I was practicing witchcraft.
Did you consider yourself a witch then?
I absolutely did. And I was not ashamed of it. I told people I was a witch. I was proud of it.
How did they respond?
In different ways. You know, some people thought I was really off the wall, you know, and that this woman's crazy. Other people were very afraid of it. Mm-hmm. It gave me a lot of control over people. I had a habit of, you know, I hung around with a lot of different circles of friends, and I'll explain that a little later, but some of them were really hardcore. Some mm-hmm. of them very criminally
right.
minded, dangerous people.
So I
would look at them and I would say, "Don't mess with me, because I'll get you, I'll get even with you, and I won't have to lay a finger on you to do it." Mm-hmm. And they were afraid of me.
Right.
You know, it gave me control, and I felt a little protected. I was like, okay, I know this person's bad, but they're not going to mess with me. I would come across bad mm-hmm. to
the
protect
devil
myself.
Made you sense that power.
Yes, I had that sense mm-hmm. of power, and that's what he does. He gives people power. He puffs them up and makes them think that they have power, that things that they are doing, that they're doing mm-hmm. it's their power, and it's not, it's demonic. You've probably heard of things where people will look at a piece of silverware and study it, and it bends, and they said they did it with their mind. Mm-hmm. They didn't do it with their mind. The devil makes them think they did. Mm-hmm. That was a demonic spirit that bent it.
Right.
You know, study a picture on the wall and make it fall.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't make it fall. It was a demonic spirit knocked it off the
right.
wall. But the devil puffs you up and makes you think you have all this power, that your mind has this power to do things. Mm-hmm. And it's all the devil's power.
Right. And I think it's important for people to realize that, because oftentimes Hollywood will glamorize witchcraft and make it seem like it's harmless. And that's what the devil wants.
Yes.
He wants people to think it's harmless.
Yes.
But it really isn't.
No, it's dangerous.
Right.
It's
we have to take a quick break here. But when we come back, we want to hear more of your story of how God set you free from that.
Okay.
Coming up next.
I had to get used to myself. I didn't think the same. I didn't talk the same. I didn't act the same. I was a completely different person.
You heard mention of the book, The Deceit of Lucifer. Using the light of God's word, this book strips the camouflage of Lucifer's insidious deceit. From demonology, seducing spirits, communicating with the dead, and astrology, this book gives biblical answers to these and many other deceits of the devil. You can go to ErnestAngeley.org to find out how to get an ebook now.
Jesus was here. Divine blood said, "Will thou be made whole?"
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
God made you. He can heal you.
How would you like a friend with supernatural powers? Someone who can protect you from the dangers of this crazy world? Someone who can whisper love and encouragement when fear overwhelms you? Someone who can guide you through life's storms and, most of all, will never leave you? Maybe you think all of this is crazy. Well, why not reach today for the person of the Holy Ghost? And yes, He will become your best friend. So come to the worship center at our website. He's waiting for you, and He's so excited to meet you.
Welcome back, and we left off with Lynn telling us how dangerous witchcraft is, and oftentimes Hollywood glamorizes it, but that's not the case.
Right, the world makes it look like a fun thing. One year for Christmas, I got a Ouija board and tarot cards. You can buy them in any toy department. They are not toys, they're real. It's demonic. In using the board, there's a spirit in the board, a demon. And this spirit told me, I was just a little girl, I didn't know, you know, anything. Mm-hmm. And this devil talked to me through the board and said, "I am a demon, my home is hell," and he gave me his name. I called on that demon even after I got into witchcraft. At this point, I wasn't in witchcraft, but a lot of people don't realize that these occult things are all a part of witchcraft,
right.
But they don't realize that's what it is.
It kind of opens the door
to it. It opens the door for devils to take you over.
Mm-hmm.
And tarot cards is, you know, they're cards that they use to read fortunes.
Mm-hmm.
My grandmother taught me to use regular playing cards, and you just use certain ones, and I learned how to do readings. And so I played with the tarot cards, but I liked grandma's way better, so I didn't really use them. But I did use the Ouija board all the way up until I got saved, and then I knew I needed to get rid of it.
So when did you, how young were you when you started?
I got the Ouija board when I was about 12. The psychic spirits experiences, those devils took me over probably 10, 11 years old, somewhere in there. I started experiencing things. I didn't always tell people what I saw, especially as a child. But then when I got older and I actually got into the witchcraft, they became stronger.
Mm-hmm.
And how I actually got into the witchcraft, I was searching. I always had a fascination for Jesus. I believed God was real. I went to a lot of different churches as a young adult, and I never found anything. Never taught about the born-again experience, never saw a church with an altar call, never heard of the rapture or the Holy Ghost, none of it. I didn't find anything. I saw things that turned me away.
Mm-hmm.
And I finally reached a point where I said, this is crazy. This God thing isn't even real. I don't need this. Mm-hmm. I can live this way, the way these people are living, without God. So there's nothing to it. Well, the devil was ready for that. And within less than 2 weeks, I was introduced to a satanic priest. And everything he said made sense. You know, it sounded so right.
Mm-hmm.
And he directed me to little out-of-the-way occult shops where I could get books on spells and candle burning and incantations and things like that. And I got a satanic Bible, and it just, that's when the devils really took me over.
Mm-hmm.
And
because you were opening up to it.
I was opening up to it, and the devil really took over. There
Now, those things that you mentioned, though, what are, you know, like candle burning?
They use candles in doing spells.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And different candles, so maybe different colors of candles for certain spells.
Okay.
Incantations are things you say, kind of like prayer. You talk to the devil, you do things. When you do spells, you're talking to the devil and you're pulling on him for something you want done, mm-hmm. just like when you're pulling on God to answer prayer. Mm-hmm. You know, they all parallel. Everything mm-hmm. the devil does parallels mm-hmm. With the way God does, but it's all for evil.
Right.
It's all and he makes people don't realize what they're really involved in.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So anyway, I met the satanic priest. He wanted me to get into a coven, which is a coven is a, it's 12 witches. It's patterned after Jesus and the 12 disciples. There's a satanic priest and 12 witches. Okay.
Wow.
And when you get into something like that, you're really getting into organized Satanism, and it's dangerous. Mm-hmm. They do,
just terrible things.
Terrible things. They, mm-hmm. Yeah. And sacrifices. Mm-hmm. They sacrifice animals. They sacrifice people, mm-hmm. babies.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I thank God because I know that the Holy Spirit was with me. He was fighting for my soul. Mm-hmm. There was a war going on for my soul. And he did not allow me to cross over certain areas. Mm-hmm. You know, I never did any sacrificing. I thank God for
yes.
that I didn't. But I never actually went into the coven. I was practicing on my own.
You're being groomed.
But I was being groomed, mm-hmm. yeah. So the deeper you get into it, the harder it is to get out, because the more you get into it, the more devils take you over. Mm-hmm. And they're controlling. I remember doing things, and in my mind, in my heart, I was saying, I don't want to do this. Mm-hmm. I don't want to do this anymore. I got to stop. But I couldn't. As I'm thinking this, I'm going right on, mm-hmm. because I couldn't. I was not in control.
Mm-hmm.
The psychic experiences were, I would see things that were going to happen that were bad, and I couldn't change it.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that started this, I had a psychic experience of someone that was going to die. I didn't know who, but I went to the family, I told them about it, and this was with some really hardcore people. And some of them thought I was crazy. Others acted on it. I said, you need to go see your mom, because there's death here. There's death in this. And so the one son, he immediately went to see his mom, because what I saw was a funeral, mm-hmm. and we were all at her
right.
house. With in less than 2 weeks, mm-hmm. he was murdered.
Wow.
And we were all there for a funeral.
Right.
You know.
So you were
but,
seeing this unfold and coming true. So tell me, what was the turning point, though, that got you away from the witchcraft?
Okay, two things. The very first way that I was dealt with was at that funeral.
Mm-hmm.
The man who did, the preacher who did the service, had to be a real man of God. He didn't soft soap anything. He didn't preach this guy into heaven.
Mm-hmm.
He talked about hell. He talked about the wiles of the devil. He talked about how he died the way he lived violently,
mm-hmm.
and he really talked about sin and what it does in your life. I felt like he was talking to me.
So that was the Holy Spirit working.
The Holy Spirit, yes.
Praise
I
God.
Was like, I don't want to do this anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I have to stop. On the way out, away from the funeral, I took off the pentagram. A pentagram is a satanic symbol. It's an inverted star. The mm-hmm. point is down. It has a goat's head in it. There's a circle around it.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a hieroglyphic at each point of the star that represents a name of Satan, Beelzebub, mm-hmm. Baal, Lucifer, mm-hmm. you know. I had that around my neck. I had on some satanic rings. I took them off and I threw them into the woods. I said, I have to be done.
Yeah.
God moved me to Akron,
mm-hmm.
away from everybody. I met someone who was my little shepherd. They invited me to Grace Cathedral because I wasn't able to get out of it. I came to Grace Cathedral. Reverend Angley prayed for me. I really didn't have any understanding of what really happened, what was going on, but he prayed for me. I went out in the spirit, and then I don't even remember what he said, but I know now he had to have said, out, you foul devils.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Right.
Then he had me say the sinner's prayer. Again, I really didn't understand what was happening, except that I changed. When I left there,
what did you feel like?
It felt good. I was slain in the spirit twice, and I'm like, what happened?
Did you feel like freedom?
I did. I felt so light. For weeks, I had to get used to myself. I didn't think the same. Mm-hmm. I didn't talk the mm-hmm. same. I didn't act the same. I was a completely different person. Mm-hmm. I didn't want any drugs, alcohol, or cigarettes. Mm-hmm. It was gone. I didn't ask to be delivered from that. It was just gone.
The Lord just took it.
Did yeah. Satan try to get you back in any way?
Oh, my goodness. He's a very sore loser.
That's true.
So don't think because you come to God that, you're not going to have any battles. Mm-hmm. He's angry. Mm-hmm. And boy, he really poured it on me. Mm-hmm. But I remember one day things were so bad and I just sat down on my basement steps and said, Lord, I must be doing something really right to be fought this hard.
Yes, praise God.
And God brought me out of that situation. Mm-hmm. But my life has been completely different since yes. then. I would never want to go back. It, mm-hmm. I love being at Grace Cathedral. I love, working mm-hmm. in the Sunday school, being with the children, and just being a part of everything here. I got the opportunity to go to the mission field mm-hmm. with Reverend Angeli, and there's a lot of witchcraft there. So I was able to give my testimony and help
right.
people there. So God took all of that and is using it for mm-hmm. good to help people.
Right.
They need to know that it's real.
Yes.
And that it is dangerous.
You were living your life in such darkness, but the Lord still drew you.
Yes.
And he drew you out of the darkness into the light.
Yes, he did.
And now you are a servant of the Lord.
Yes.
And you're serving him and yes. helping others. And yes. I think this testimony is really going to help a lot of people.
Yes, yes. What a huge blessing. And at this time, I'd like to just give everybody an opportunity to pray, to ask Jesus in their heart, to receive that deliverance from whatever it may be. Mm-hmm. Friend, just pray with me now.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
To ask Jesus Christ in your heart. You may be going through something very rough in your life. Maybe you need your deliverance. When you ask Jesus Christ in your heart, he will set you free. He'll break those bondages and move in a wonderful way. So pray with me now and say, oh God, save my soul. Forgive me for my sins. But I have come home to serve you the rest of my life. And I believe that the blood of Jesus washes away all of my sins. Come into my heart, Jesus. Come on in, Jesus. Friend, if you meant that prayer, you have Jesus in your heart. What a huge blessing to have Jesus in their heart.
Yes.
God has done so many wonderful things for you. He's blessed you. He's
again
helped you
and again.
So much. Well, this was a great program. And
yes, thank you for being with us
yes.
today.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Yes, it was a big blessing. And thank you for being on this program. And friend, I'd like you to stay tuned with us because we have something very special for you.
Miracles are real. I was made whole after having a stroke from a torn carotid artery.
Miracles are real. I was healed of kidney disease back in 1969. I wouldn't have been here, but here I am.
People receiving miracles from God. Friend, the Bible says a believer would lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. If you're in need of a miracle, come to our Friday night miracle service and expect God to move for you.
If you are enjoying today's program, let us know by sending in a donation. Your gift of love will enable others to be lifted up into the grace of God.
This was a very powerful program today, and we're so grateful that Lynn was with us today to share her experience of how God delivered her from witchcraft. And parents, those of you out there watching, let this program be a warning to you to not let your children get involved with the Ouija board and other demonic crafts, that it's very dangerous. And we want to encourage you that if you're in that kind of bondage, that you can be set free, you can be delivered. You can come to one of our services and receive prayer and receive your deliverance just like Lynn did.
Yes, on that Friday night miracle service, how Lynn was delivered, you can be delivered. And we have these wonderful services, and this is a great opportunity to come to Grace Cathedral. And what a huge blessing, because you'll be able to receive your deliverance for whatever it is. Maybe you need deliverance for smoking, drinking, or drugs. Lynn was doing these things, but God delivered her. God set her free from witchcraft. And maybe there's something that they need.
Right, there's power in the blood. Never underestimate the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. It can set you free from anything.
Yes, and I just love how Lynn was, you know, ready to be set free, and the Lord was willing to work with her, and God just brought her all together. The Holy Spirit was just dealing with her. Friend, maybe the Holy Spirit is dealing with you today. Well, you can come and be with us, and what a huge blessing. What a wonderful opportunity you have. And now we have a wonderful song that I know that you're going to be blessed with by the Holy Soul Trio, and the title of this song is Come Home. So listen and be blessed.
God bless you.
If this program has blessed you today, let us know on our Facebook page. You're also invited to attend any of our services. Come and witness the wonderful things of heaven for yourself. This program has been made possible by the friends and partners of Ernest Angley Ministries.